COVID-19 pandemic is greatly unprecedented and will have a lasting impact in the future of work. We all know that things will never be the same again, and there's a lot of uncertainties in the future, and most companies should understand that they need to transform themselves, because if they don't transform, they will not be around for the long term. Today, I would like to share with all of you 5 key points that, in my opinion, have changed and will continue to change and shape our future as we navigate through the pandemic and through other forms of disruptions. The first one is the need to invest in technology. Investing in technology is like investing in the overall health and survival of your organization. In EY, our new strategy is investing technology in everything that we do, whether that is working from home using technology, whether that is interfacing with clients using more and more technology, collaborating with internal working teams using technology, or using different technologies around artificial intelligence to do a lot of analytical work to understand data better. Understanding how this data moves and what this data are telling us. The more you use and the more you learn about technology, the better off you will be. It will make your work much more interesting as it takes away a lot of the manual tasks so you can focus your time and skills to so much more value-adding results. The right technology guarantees quality, reliability, consistency, and obviously speed, security, and integrity. During the pandemic, we have seen and we have reaped the benefits of our firm's investment in our technology infrastructure. We wouldn't have survived without good technology. That is why our response to COVID-19 was very quick. It was rapid and seamless, and we have fully enabled 100% of our employees to work from home several weeks before our government announced the lockdown. Takes a lot of planning and preparations to do that, but having the really great technology that comes with it will make it really successful. So more than 3 months now into the lockdown, we continue to do business as usual while our employees continue to work from home. And it's primarily because our technology has enabled us to do so. Second is we continue to consider data as gold. We all know that numbers do not lie. Business owners, entrepreneurs, and consumers depend heavily on numbers to make decisions and to establish that what we are doing is right. So with the remote work as a business setup and with the rise of new methods and technologies to help us perform our work, data is necessary to ensure that we are really getting things done and we are doing them correctly. So I believe everybody has been using data even before the pandemic, but the need to make use of data to better understand business trends, employee engagement, and productivity will continue to accelerate given the new way of working now. People and mostly a lot of us are now working away from the office site. The third thing that I want to share with you is that we should consider resiliency as important as productivity and efficiency. You see, the Philippines is heavily affected by natural calamities. And this year alone, we were hit by calamities like the Taal volcano incident, the recent typhoons, and now the COVID-19 crisis. So I believe our BCP team has been one of the busiest teams in our organization, ensuring business is not interrupted during calamities so that our clients will continue to rely on exceptional delivery of services from our firms. The pandemic has probably caught us all by surprise, challenging our BCP protocols and plans that we have put in place, but this is also an opportunity for us to test the reliability of our plans, isn't it? So while productivity and efficiency are essential components of our response to disruptions, keeping ourselves resilient, agile, and nimble are equally imperative. We need to have the right mindset, the discipline, and the emotional preparedness to combat unforeseen and difficult situations. And these are all necessary attributes of good business leaders. So we as Filipinos are known to be highly resilient, and that is one thing that we should all be proud of. And also the Bayanihan spirit is also something that we should be proud of. So next is, we know that working remotely is here to stay. So according to a Gartner survey, Gartner is one of the world's leading research and advisory companies, about 48% of employees around the world will likely continue to work remotely even after the COVID-19 pandemic. So working from home could be relatively new in the Philippine setting, but it has become, I think, the most sensible and most realistic solution as the new way of working. As organizations then shift their operations to working remotely, the need to use technology to stay connected and the need to collaborate digitally are very, very important. With service delivery and business transactions moving to a digital space, we need to prepare to adjust the overall employee experience while keeping our company culture thriving. I would say that working from home is a great privilege, and it can be you can still be very, very productive, even more productive than when you're working from your offices. But obviously, this can be problematic if it's not well managed. So I encourage the managers and the business leaders to make sure that they provide enough supervision so that the work from home privileges is neither abused nor not taken advantage of. The next one is... our companies would be defined on how we have reacted during the pandemic. So prior to COVID-19, I think organizations would implement programs and campaigns or advertisements to actually enhance or advertise their brand and to create, you know, pleasing perception about their organizations with the goals of increasing sales or winning more clients or attracting potential candidates for employment. Now, with COVID-19, our clients, our stakeholders, and most especially our employees and prospective employees may start defining our organizations based on how we have responded to the crisis. So things like, how did we protect our people and our people's jobs? How did we protect our clients? And what have we done to help the society and the government in the national battle for this crisis. So COVID-19 obviously has caused a lot of devastation to businesses and families in many countries all over the world. But this has also forced us to fast track our way to innovation and integration of technologies in our way of life. Regardless of the kind of disruption that may come our way, business leaders should put these three important P's at the core of the role. And this is just my point of view. The first one is to protect your people and to protect your people's jobs. The second is to protect your business and protect your clients. And the last one is to play an active role in nation building. Thank you very much, Richard. It has been a great honor to be here. Good morning again, and have a pleasant day, everybody.